Are we recording?
Yeah, let's go.
Here we go.
Yay.
Jana Reacts.
Jana Reacts episode.
Are we numbering them? I don't even know.
I guess not. I don't know what number.
It's like 12 or
12, 13. 13
somewhere around there.
Somewhere like that.
Okay, do a real beginning.
All right. Hello, everybody, and welcome to Nathan on Shuffle. We're here with our latest Jana Reacts show.
Hi.
Where my wife reacts to some prog music. She's not quite a prog fan, I wouldn't say.
Not quite.
But she likes certain prog. She's starting to like more and more, I think.
Yeah, that's accurate.
It's fair to say?
Yeah.
Good. Not total torture, right?
Oh, no. I'm enjoying it a lot.
Okay. I feel like sometimes in the comments, everyone's like, man, your wife's putting up with a lot to have to listen to all this. So I just want to make sure everyone knows you're not being forced into this.
I'm not being tortured. No. This is great. I'm glad that you're able to share this music with me. And that while I may not always appreciate it on the same level that you do, like, I enjoy it and I like seeing you happy. So it's good.
It works out.
It's been fun. Yeah.
Good. So as our usual thing here, I have a list that I've compiled of notable prog anthems. I found it through Prog Magazine, so it's a long list of 100 prog songs that are notable. And then I've also added a few of, like, people's requests and things that I think would be good to react to. So kind of building up a playlist, and we just press shuffle and whatever comes up.
See what comes up. We react to. We don't know.
So that's kind of the name of the game. So don't get mad at me for the choice.
Sometimes it's like I'm crossing my fingers for something short, I tend to not like the longer songs, but the ones that I have heard have been really good, so I'm okay if we do a long song, so.
We'll see.
Yeah, we'll see.
What type we get this time. So I guess, as we always say, shuffle the song.
Shuffle the song!
Alright, let's see what's coming up. Ooh, this is one of my favorites. Oh, sorry, it's another long one.
Oh yeah? 25 minutes? Oops.
Well, there's a lot of epics on here, so we're bound to hit them every so often.
It's okay. It'll be all right.
But this is the Flower Kings, Stardust We Are, from 1997.
Oh, like a more recent
recent
one. They're kind of a recent group.
Yeah.
Then?
They're from Sweden.
Roine Stolt is in this one.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, we've covered Transatlantic, which features Roine Stolt as well. So this is his own band, the Flower Kings.
Okay. And is he like the lead singer or?
He's lead singer, guitarist. You know, they have a couple singers.
Oh, okay.
So he sings certain sections, and they have Hasse Froberg is the other singer.
Hasse Froberg?
Yeah, I think that's how you say it.
Oh my gosh, I love that name.
Hopefully I'm right.
Well, be forever that.
But yeah, it's kind of cool because I'm doing a show talking about Flower Kings, so this kind of works out well.
I feel
lucky to shuffle into it. Sorry. So, yeah, hopefully more details upcoming. I hope that's still happening, and it should be fun.
Yeah, and if not, then we're editing this part out.
Yeah, no one will ever see this, or no.
They'll never know. So, Flower Kings.
Flower Kings, right? So,
okay.
Yeah, this is a classic, in my opinion. I think this may be their best and most notable prog epic. You know, they're known for their long prog songs, this was on the prog anthems list, I remember, so.
Nice.
Cool.
All right.
I like some good modern prog,
Let's
so
do it.
This is exciting to me. Hopefully, I know you're going to say it's too long, but,
but so
you'll, I hope you like parts of it, at least.
I'm sure I will. I usually do.
All right, so let's.
I'm not a complete curmudgeon. Just sometimes.
Okay, let's play the song.
It's like they lure you in with this soft guitar music on.
Thank you.
something.
Thank you.
part before.
Positive, cool thing. like that. Yeah, to the theme of the song.
Yeah, oh yeah.
Stardust.
Stardust.
The twinkling stars. Part. The iconic intersection.
I see how we fly so heavenly high, swim in the ocean and spin the stars, and so the greatness will fall apart. So don't forget the human touch, the word of mouth, this roundabout we love so much.
Yeah, we've done that.
I see our thoughts are running free, run for leader and see my God. Once again, we're paying blood. So don't forget the human trial, the cry of love, the spark of life, dance through the fire. Stars, build this window beneath the pool, lend a hand to drown a fool. See the saviors come so cheap, we lose our touch and down we go into the deep. Driving down the memory lane, dusty dreams from a fading sun. Remember how run, we'll play the stars, we'll walk the moon, we'll burn the rope, lay down the gun.
You don't trust him. Then another part.
That's the end?
Yeah, that's the end of it.
Huh. I liked the end of that. I thought the end of that was really, really pretty.
Yeah.
Like the last minute or so. Like that was just...
That's pretty, huh?
Really, really lovely and really... I don't know, just like that fairy tale feeling.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's the vibe they're going for.
No, I think that works. Yeah.
Okay.
Kind of just, you know, they're always very, you know, happy, sunny, positive mm-hmm. kind of vibe, I think.
I appreciate that.
Yeah.
So. I like this one. Of course, I think it's too long. I
yeah, that's just a given.
I find myself like losing attention and thinking about a million other things while this song is playing. It doesn't mean that I don't think that the song is good.
Yeah,
that's me. now there are several different like ending spots. Like I'm like, is that the end? That's not the end.
Right.
This hasn't been 25 minutes yet. But lots of like points like that where it transitioned into a new part, but I felt like it was all the same song. I didn't feel like it was a lot of like different, like super different sounding. So I liked that
it flows together well.
I thought it flowed really well.
Yeah.
That's a great way to put it. Mm-hmm. I liked the lyrics because we were following along with the lyrics here. And they were really good. I especially like the section in the end. Stardust We Are. I mean, it's the
name of the song.
The name of the song, yeah. Stardust We Are, close to divine Stardust We Are. See how we shine. So to me, that feels like we're like we're all important and we're all like so close to being divine and divinity. Like it's that's how I took it.
Yeah.
So and that everybody's important. There was another one. Go higher to the first section.
Okay.
There was a line in there. Yeah. There was a line in there. Okay, pause. We'll cut this part out while I find it. Oh, yeah. This line here. Once touch the stars, then back to the grind. So it felt like you're reaching for things and maybe you don't quite get it, but you should keep going because you're important. And... I don't know. like you're important and you're imperative to this world and to the people around you. So am I interpreting this like am I totally off the wall?
No, I think you're right. I think Roy Nastol especially has a lot of spirituality, I think, in his lyrics. So I think it's kind of maybe talking about like how we may seem kind of small and insignificant here, and life can be kind of, you know, kind of a short experience, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
But we all are kind of part of a grander, you know, universe or...
A grand master plan.
Yeah. Because I don't think he's necessarily, like, Christian, but more like, you know, about the universe and you know, kind of the generic, how there's a higher power above us and that we have greater purpose,
I
think.
We have a great purpose and we
part
have,
of it all.
We have importance and it's imperative that we... live our lives and do good things like mm-hmm. with our lives. That's what I was feeling a lot during it. And, I liked it. I think that the music, the sound of the music and the tone of the music really supported that message.
Yeah.
So I really liked it.
Yeah.
It was good.
They do that. They have like kind of this grand epic.
Yeah.
You know, that's where prog to me kind of works well. It brings that kind of epicness to that story. To that idea of like a higher being or, mm-hmm. you know, the grand universe and all that kind of stuff. And that's partly why I like them and other bands that kind of go into that. So, yeah, I think that's how I interpret the song as well. So,
all right, cool. Well, I liked it.
Well, that's good. Just too long.
Of course. But that's all right.
But that's kind of, part of.
That's just my preference.
Yeah.
It's still amazing. It's still great and wonderful. So, I think.
That's good.
People should listen to it, and I put it on my playlist. And
oh, good.
I may skip it at times, or maybe I'll skip towards the end because I like the last.
You
part
like the last section the best, yeah.
Where the lyrics it says part three.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's where I mean, I liked all of it, but that's like where I really like.
Yeah.
Like, oh god, this is good. It's got a good. I mean, I just really liked it.
Yeah.
That part.
It kind of builds to that section.
Yeah.
I feel like when they play. Like part of this live, sometimes they'll just kind of play that end part, just because, you know, there's so many different songs to play, and this would be such a huge chunk of the concert. So I feel like they like this section too. You know, it's kind of the grand finale and conclusion to what they're talking about.
They agree with me. That's so nice of them.
You're the expert, so they bow down to your opinions.
Oh, man.
So, yeah.
Not true.
I'm glad you liked it.
Yeah,
I know it's a lot to take in. There's a lot going on in the instrumental sections, and it's lengthy, but I really love... This is one of my favorite songs, so I'm glad we covered it.
It was nice.
Yeah.
I liked it.
All right, so thanks, everybody, for watching this video, and enjoy the music, as we say. Subscribe if you like what we're doing and appreciate this kind of music and our content. And so thank you guys for everything.
All right, enjoy the music.
All right, bye.
Bye.